Assalamualaikum.
Waalaikum assalam warahmatullahi
wabarakatuh. Today we come across a lot of Muslim girls who keep a condition before marriage that their prospective husbands should keep a beard or should not keep a beard. So what is the Islamic actually ruling on keeping a beard? It's like if it has to be kept, what is the ruling of keeping it? And a person, can we consider a person without a beard as having less iman?
Well, that's a question that there are some Muslim, maybe met someone who doesn't marry property course, possibly. To put condition that you should have a beard. So is keeping a beard or not keeping a beard haram or halal? What are the rulings? And can she put a condition? Fine. And if the person does not keep a beard, does he have less iman? As far as keeping a beard is concerned, the scholars are divided. Either it is farz or some scholars say mustahab. Mustahab is encouraged. I'm not talking about those scholars who don't consider a scholar. Some scholars say it's not required only. So these don't come in the category of scholars for me. What fatwa you want, go on the internet, you'll get. You get fatwa not to keep a beard, is farz also, it's not allowed. Very interest is allowed. All fatwas you'll get. I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the good scholars, the respected scholars, those scholars who speak on Quran Hadith. So those who are strict to say that keeping a beard is a farz. Some who are lenient among the good scholars may say it is mustahab. Mustahab means encouraged, a sunnah. Whatever it is, if you say not keeping a beard, does it mean less iman? Even if it's fard and you don't keep it, less iman. Even if it's mustahab and you don't keep it, less iman. So your question regarding not keeping a beard, does it mean less iman? Yes. But certain less iman is accepted, certain less iman is not accepted. Well, the iman of the sahabas also kept on going up and down. That doesn't mean that if a less iman is a beiman. The beiman is a different word, you know. When you use the word in Hindi, or a person that is a kafir, it's not like that. You can always go to a higher level. Now coming to your question, what is the length of the beard? See, because the hadith of Muhammad SAW, of Sahih Bukhari, in the book of Dress, volume number 7, hadith number 781, where the Beloved Prophet SAW said, that do the opposite of what the pagans did. Hadith 780 and 781, that trim your moustaches and let your beard grow. The same hadith for the Ibn Umar, may Allah please with him, he is the sahaba who narrated the hadith. It says that the Prophet said, do the opposite of what the pagans did. Let your beard grow, trim your moustaches. And then, after performing Hajj, he took a fist, and below the fist, he trimmed it. So based on this hadith, there are some scholars who go on their side, look, keep the beard, means let it be as long, don't cut only. But there are no less than 11 Sahih hadith which say that the sahabas trimmed the beard. So there are a very limited group of scholars who say that let the beard grow, means don't cut only. How to grow the beard? The way the sahabas did. How the sahabas did? 11 hadith saying that they trimmed. How did they trim? After one fist. So if you want to know, the ideal size is one fist. Ideal size. After one fist, little bit of the jada ho gaya to trim karo. One fist say 1 centimeter, 1 inch, no problem. But every week you trim, every fortnight, every month, what you want, but trim it. So the right size, if your ideal size, is one fist. But first thing, at least keep a beard. That doesn't mean a person who doesn't keep a beard of one fist is a kafir. No, it's not like that. If you see, the more you follow Quran Hadith, the more iman rises. So first keep a beard at least. Namaz padne padega, paanch time padne padega, sunnat bina, nafil, par namaz to padho. Farz hai bhai. Well, 5 times padho. Theek, only first padho bhai. Then do sunnah, then you can do, then you get tahajjud, you know. So everything can be the first keeping a beard, alhamdulillah. If you ask me, a person who keeps a beard but doesn't give one fist, fine, good, mashallah. Maybe he's not keeping one fist, he may not be aware of it. Tomorrow, if you're aware of it, you start keeping. It is ignorance. But yet if a person knows and yet doesn't keep one fist, I cannot say that. Fine. And I'm not looking handsome, I'm looking handsome. You know, so I always tell a person that if the beard is good, good, mashallah, good growth, like the brother next to you, mashallah, very good growth. So if you keep a beard with a good growth, alhamdulillah. But a person who doesn't have a good growth like me, my growth is anytime. It's not good. You know, first time I kept a beard, I was medical college, oh, wow, mashallah, noor chehre pe. I know it doesn't look good. So I said, okay, fine. Mashallah, person is encouraging me. But the hadith of the Prophet, you know the thing that if you cannot read the Quran, and if you read with stuttering, you get double sawab. So based on that, using my analogy, if the beard looks good and you keep, alhamdulillah, if the beard doesn't look good and you keep, you get double sawab. Achha lagta hai sawab milega, not that you won't get sawab next to you. But if it doesn't look good and you're keeping, you'll get double sawab. मैं अल्लाह के रसूल के लिए कर रहा हूँ. So both ways you get sawab. One more thing, if your beard doesn't grow, then what it goes in there, you know, if the Chinese people, my son is saying, the speaker is coming on peace TV, no beard. But I said, have a beard. And my son is telling, have a beard, but small beard if you see, very close, you close up, you know. My son was telling, oh, this person doesn't have a beard. I said, you can't just blame anyone. I mean, that was a good sheikh, mashallah. But you know, there are some sheikhs because of the growth. It may come because of the origin. He may be an Indian, yet may not have a good beard. So as long as it is there, so your iman is there. So if you are the right size, it is one fist. You can trim it below the fist. But at least keep a beard, keeping a beard, mashallah, the sign. And I've given the talk on it. The label shows the intent, wear it. So if you hear that talk, you get more details about this question. But the main question, can a wife put a condition before marriage? Yes, she can put. Even if we say it is far, she can put. Even if you call Mustaf, she can put. Even if you say Muba, you can put. No one says it's haram to keep a beard. No scholar says that. Maximum they may say, rakha re rakha chalenga. So even if it's Muba, if you belong to that group of scholar which is absolutely lenient, yet the wife can put a condition saying that you want a beard, because that comes in Muba condition for those. Anyway, if the wife puts a condition, you consider that the wife is virtuous. Right? There are some wives will put that, oh, I don't like the beard. No, because it pokes. It pokes, you get more sawab. If it pokes and you don't like, you get more sawab.